Hi there. It's Geek Fest month at the Kalamazoo Public Library, and we are here to work on a writing prompt. My name is Kai, and I work with Read and Write Kalamazoo, better known as ROC, and we are an organization that celebrates and amplifies youth voice. So we are all about reading and writing, and today I am here to talk to you about a specific writing prompt that I want you to try out for me. So, the theme for today is Afrofuturism. I'm wondering how many of you have ever heard the term Afrofuturism. Raise your hand if you've heard of Afrofuturism. Have you heard that word before? How about this? Raise your hand if you've seen or heard of the movie Black Panther. I probably got more hands that second time. So I'm asking about Black Panther because Black Panther is an example of Afrofuturism. So we're going to learn more about it today, but I want you to know if you've heard of or seen Black Panther, you already know a lot about Afrofuturism. So what is Afrofuturism? Afrofuturism is the reimagining of a future filled with arts, science, and technology seen through a Black lens. The term was coined by a cultural critic named Mark Derry in an essay written a quarter century ago titled Black to the Future. In that essay, Derry took a look at speculative fiction. So speculative fiction is fiction with settings other than the real world. So it involves supernatural elements, futuristic elements, or other imagined elements. And Derry considered those elements within the African diaspora. So what makes Afrofuturism significantly different from standard science fiction is that it is steeped in ancient African traditions and Black identity. A narrative that simply features a Black character is not enough. That's not what we're talking about when we say Afrofuturism. And it's not even enough to feature a Black character in a futuristic world. To be Afrofuturism, this is something that's going to be rooted in Black culture, and it's something that celebrates the uniqueness and innovation of Black culture. So, as I said in the beginning, the popular film Black Panther is a great example of Afrofuturism. So, we can consider the characters that are in that movie. We have Princess Shuri, who is a tech genius, and she's the smartest person in Wakanda. She's responsible for the creation and maintenance of sophisticated gadgets for her brother, T'Challa, who is the Black Panther. Wakanda is a fictional East African country that has never been colonized and is steeped in Blackness. It's a utopian society that also boasts one of the world's richest resources, vibranium. Because white supremacy never intruded on Wakandan culture and its people, ancient African traditions remain common practice in Wakanda. So, why is any of this important? Afrofuturism is important because it gives full autonomy to Black people to develop an entire universe and say, this is ours. Afrofuturism is the intersection of science fiction and African pride. Black people deserve to see themselves leading the way in real or abstract futures. Afrofuturism embraces an infinite range of possibilities for Black people to live free and whole in a future of their desire. So, now it's time for a writing prompt. I want us to think about how we can be Afrofuturists. What can we write? What can we say about the future? So, for today's writing prompt, I want us to reimagine a story that we love as Afrofuturism. So we're gonna take a story that we know and love, and we are going to think about how must this story shift for it to be Afrofuturist. So we are going to imagine the future. And when we imagine the future, we're gonna pay close attention to what we imagine and who we imagine in that future. It's important to remember that Afrofuturism is a mixture of science fiction, fantasy, and African mythologies. So those are some important characteristics of Afrofuturism. Also, Afrofuturism challenges the world as it exists now. What a cool idea, right? To be able to challenge the world as it is now, to say, how should our world be? How could it be better? What if everyone in our nation had equal access to technology? What if women were equal members of society? When you're writing, think to yourself, what role does a powerful nation play in helping others? So think of Afrofuturism as a symbol of hope in both the present and the past. I hope that this lesson in Afrofuturism inspires you and makes you feel like an Afrofuturist, makes you feel like you can tell these stories. If the stories we tell are ones that allow everyone to exist and to thrive in the world of tomorrow, perhaps we'll be more inspired to make that world our reality.